Hi, I thought I'd try and make a quick video here to go over some items when you are working with parts that you import into SolidWorks. And you probably already figured this out, of course. Pick a plane, go to Insert, click on Import the DXF, open it, and you get this. Now, to start out with, I just usually just hit finish, and it's because all I'm trying to do is find out if this is millimeters, inches, feet, hectares, whatever, you know. So it very rarely will put it on the origin, and I'll show you something about that later, how to do that. But I just go down here to measure, and I just get a measurement. The whole idea is you're just trying to figure out, you know, now there, if you're going to put something on your desk, I doubt it's going to be 21 feet long. So right there, that's my big red flag that this is probably a millimeters of the units it wants to bring in. But let's look at something first. You probably want to set your computer up in SolidWorks for dual measurements if you haven't already. And you can just go ahead and skip this if you haven't. But if not, go to measurements, open up this, and check the dual units, make 1 millimeters and 1 inches. And it comes in really handy. Always set this back 4 places for inches and 3 for millimeters and 2 for decimal places for angles, because you want that accuracy. You can always make your drawings less. But now you can see as we're getting the dual measurement there. So I just wanted to show you that. And also, if you click on this, we're in inches right now. Now you don't have to restart if you happen to find yourself in inches. As you know, you can probably go down here and click this, and you can just go back and forth. So if you click on millimeters, it'll turn off your sketch, so you have to turn it back on. And you can see now everything's in millimeters. And I do a lot of things where part of it's in inches and part of it's in millimeters, and that's how I just go back and forth with that. And so I'll just go back and forth, but most of the time I just use my measure tool and I can tell between the inches and the millimeters. So as you can see there's the error there. That this part could have been made in Corel Draw or something like that. So you got to beware of that when you pull things in and you import them. Another item is that I use this part that I set up in the template, or this metric part. Now you might be using that or this one that just came with it. The problem with the one that just comes with it is that when you open it up and start a part, I mean, we're using SolidWorks, and the reason we're using it is for accuracy, and that's just not, see how much you can get there for actually right there. You can see how far past the decimals. But if we put in 3/16, it comes up as 0.19, and you know, that's not good enough. So you might want to set your item and set up a template so that every time when you go down here to options, you can do it on each document if you want. You go to units, and then you can set it. I always set 4 places past for inches. I even set this for 4 past the decimal. The reason is you can set your documents when you print them out for whatever the people want. If they only want, you know, 3 past or whatever. A lot of my metalworking people, they just want, when they're on the press break, they just want, you know, they want 0.188 instead of 0.1875. But if you want to set up a template, just open up a part, their default one. Before you do anything else, go directly up and change the units. Hit OK. Don't do anything else, and go up to Save As. And it's in a part now, but save it as a template. And it'll take you directly to where your templates will be. And put a name there that you'll recognize, like David's, you know, part metric, David's, you know, inch parts or whatever you want to do, and then save it. I'm not going to, because I already have them saved here. But if you do that, then it'll come up with better accuracy every time you open up a part. Now, we'll look at it again here. I just think it's important. I see so many people that only go three places past, and you're in the digital format, so it doesn't matter if it's 4, 5, 6, whatever. I think 4 is good enough, but then it holds that accuracy because you can always bring it back down if you want to, but it's kind of hard to go the other way. The other thing is when you know it's going to be a metric part, I go ahead and open it in my metric part. You don't have to. But I wanted to show you that we're going to import this part again. Is that they give you the option, which you probably know this. You go to next, go up here, and then you can import it in millimeters. And there you go. Now it's going to come in probably as it was designed. Just click that off. That doesn't matter. Click on that top view or whatever plane view you're on. And you can see it's way away from the origin. So you want to always, always on your SolidWorks parts. If there's anything that's possibly symmetrical or there's any way to center your part on the origin in any way at all, even if it's just the thickness, you know, make it mid-plane, one go one way and the other. But on here, you click on the line, awaken the midpoint, click on the line again, awaken the midpoint, and set it there. Now that's a good sign because it's saying it's perfectly horizontal and it's in the center. So that's what we want. So whoever designed this, that's good. They made this thing centered. Look over here, and this is another good sign. These little circles are directly off the center, horizontal. So once I saw this, I thought, oh, we got this now because we have something to base the origin off of. So now we set up those little guidelines. Now we can just kind of drag over the whole top of everything, highlight everything. And you've seen this before. Go to Tools, go to Sketch Tools, go to Move, and then click on that center area, that little base point or that center point that we're going to put on the origin. We click on it, and it allows us to move it. And it's not going to set it to it. It's just going to put it right over the top of it. So we know it's there. Now it's not set there because if I drag on one of these things, it's not locked in place. See, it's kind of gets all funky. No big deal. Just hit undo. It takes it back to what it was. But here's a little trick for putting that line or centering it right on that origin when it's hard to know what to click. Click on the origin first. Hold down the control key. And then click in that same area over the origin again. Hit coincident. And it automatically, you see that line turned black. So we midpoint, or we centered that line, or at least made it coincident onto the origin. So it kind of gave us something to start out with. This part is still not perfect because we really don't know who drew it, if they drew it on Coral Draw or something more accurate. So what I like to do is turn off that sketch and on the same plane start a brand new sketch over the top of it. So now, no matter what we do, we're not going to screw up or move that original sketch. And another thing is use this convert entities. And so what we're going to do is kind of make a test item. With this, you kind of saw how long it took to kind of play around with their drawing and try and correct it. Now, I thought you mentioned 2 hours or something like that. And heck, it might take that long. If I was screwing with it too, because you don't know what they did and where they were drawing it or what their theory was. And they probably didn't draw this in one step either. Maybe they did, but I have a feeling they drew it in different steps, just like we would in SolidWorks. So all I'm doing here is I'm just picking a line or lines, and then I'm hitting convert entities. And I'm going to speed this up here in a second by 4 times and just speed through this. But it seems like a lot of work here, but think of how long it took to try and screw with their drawing. So all we're doing with this is, if you see, when we hit that convert entities, it puts the line and it holds it to where it's supposed to be, but the ends you can move. So what we're doing is we're moving all these ends past all these fillets. And we're kind of being able to figure out much faster what the theory of this thing was and what the major dimensions were to start out the part. Okay, so now I'm slow down here again. So you just bring them past each other so they're overhanging, and then you go up here to this trim entities, hold down your mouse button and just slide it past, and it'll cut them right off. That's it. It's that easy. Now, if you accidentally, I'm going to do it on purpose here, hit the wrong one, no big deal. Just hit undo, and it'll put it back. Now, you're going to have to go ahead and turn on your trim entities again, and there you go. Now, the reason I'm doing this is that now I can find out what the pure measurements were, what he really started out with, whoever designed this, of what they were thinking. It gives me something to measure. Like I said, it seems like a lot of work, but think of how long it takes to try and screw with this, trying to get measure past all of those. So right there is probably what they started out with. So that's probably what I would start out with. Now you can copy and paste this into a new sketch or whatever, or you can put some measurements on here. Now if you click on these, click up above to make it make this dimension driven, because it's being driven by that first sketch. And that's what we want it to do. Because all we're putting these measurements on for now is so that we can go back and look later to see what they were. And now we're starting to see their logic. See, there's a nice pure. When I say pure, I'm just meaning integer. There's not a bunch of stuff behind the decimal. You start seeing what people were thinking on here. Now, a great trick to do is if you're not sure if it's the right item or if it's whatever, go to the fillets and click on there. Very rarely will they make a fillet like 1.9627 billion or whatever. They'll usually make it 1 millimeter or 2 millimeters or 1/8 inch or whatever. So that's a good way to see if your part's in the correct scale. So anyway, we're just marking all these out. Now, you wouldn't have to do this. You can use your measure tool. But I work on so many items a day, I just cannot remember measurements, and I don't trust my memory anymore. So I'll do this, and I'll just take a screen capture of that and put it on my other screen so I can watch it, and then I'll just redraw this part in 5 minutes. Like I said, this seems like a lot of work, but think how long it takes to try and correct somebody else's work or to correct this. Or you can just copy and paste this and put it into something else and then start from there. So you're seeing the theory. They're 10 millimeters off from the side on each side. So you can kind of see how it goes. And now you can see here, get the measurement, so we know that that's 31 millimeters. And if you go to that part that I did for you, you can see that you can use that a rectangle and then make it a guideline rectangle or a construction line rectangle, and you can make those little holes pretty easy. Now this looked kind of funky, and I'm thinking, people are lazy. Nobody goes to that much effort to draw that and all by itself, all at one time. So they must be doing something else. So you just get in here and you start playing with this, and you think, they probably started out with a rectangle. Now that's probably not going to go. You probably want to go from a line to a point. No big deal. Where it's red there, click on it, right click on it, and then hit delete, and it'll just go away. Go from the line down to a point. Let's see. Let's go to this one. Try this one first. Hold down the control key. Just hit coincident. And there. All we're doing is using this as a guide to see what was the size of the rectangle they started out with. Now you're starting to see, they went through and they made a bunch of rectangles here first. Then they went back in the next step after that's already cut out. Then they could just sit there and pull the circle right off the corners there. Now on here, I'm not even lining them up, but on this one I will. You can see it's not really stuck to there. You can pull it around. But if you need to, if you want to, click on it, hit it in the control key, click on that guide sketch, and there you can lock it in place. And then you can go up here, use your measure tool, or you can use this. Once again, it's going to ask you to make this dimension driven, but you can see now it's all making sense. They're using 1 millimeter diameter circles. Then after those are done, then they're going back and they're using a 0.5 millimeter radius. So now it's all pretty simple. You see, these guys are lazy just like the rest of us. They know exactly. We're doing it multiple steps. And so then you can see how big you need to make your sides when you make your rectangle. So it's all just about trying to figure out the theory of the part, you know, figure out what the guy was thinking when he made it, and then redraw it quickly. So you can probably do this in 10 minutes. Okay, that's all.